So I've brought you to Astwood Fishery for 48 hours. I've literally grown up at this place. I can remember my first ever session fishing here, and the first lake I fished was Bluebell. One of my mates, Ben, and we used to fish this place quite a lot. And that's pretty much where I caught my first ever, you know, decent sized carp. It was about a 9-10 pound ghostie, caught at the back of the island on Bluebell. And I was just fishing a simple waggler set up with, you know, like a halibut pellet on the hook or something like that. When I started out fishing, that was, you know, a really, really big fish, and it basically hooking into that carp, yeah, it just literally got me hooked on carp fishing. I don't know why, but I always keep on coming back to this place. There's something that keeps on drawing me back. Everyone has their favourite fisheries and their favourite venues. The thing that draws me back to Astwood is just how peaceful it is, how, you know, secluded it is. All your stresses of everyday life, it just leaves you. It's a really, really special place to me. So there's three pools on site. You've got Smoky Joe, which is the one I'm fishing at the moment. You've got Bluebell, and then you've got Boudelier, which is more of the match pool. I think there's about 40 pegs on Boudelier, so it's just a perfect match pool. Smoky Joe and Bluebell, more this is where your big carp are, and there's the bigger fish are in Bluebell. But there's also plenty of silvers in Smoky Joe and Bluebell. But I love all the pools here, to be honest with you. Boudelier, if I want to do a bit of match style fishing or a bit, you know, some match videos, I will go on Boudelier. But for specimen carp fishing, it's out Smoky Joe and Bluebell. But as I said, the bigger carp are in Bluebell. And that brings me over to this session. So I got here at about 4 or 5 o'clock on Saturday. I planned to do a 48 hour session, and before I even started, you know, setting the bivvy up, I spotted some fish in amongst the rushes and, you know, quite close in. So I got my 9 foot 2¾ stalking rod out, set up a free lining rig, and I managed to stalk 2 carp before I even got the brolly set up. I managed to get the brolly set up in the end. I got the rods out for the night. I managed 3 fish within, you know, the space of 10-15 minutes at night, and I decided to bring the rods in just because it started to get really mad, and the rods kept on getting tangled up, and to be honest with you, I was quite shattered. I've had a very, very busy week, so I decided to bring the rods in and start again in the morning. Now I'm on 16 fish now. Every fish except from one or two has been about 9-10 pound or over. All my fish pretty much been caught on just free lining, either a bunch of dead maggots or bread over just sloppy pellet and mushed up bread. The aim of this video basically is just to give you an insight to one of my favourite venues. I absolutely love Astwood. I'll keep on coming back to this place, you know, down here, even if it's just for a couple of hours, just to do a bit of surface fishing or stalking. I just absolutely love this place. So I hope this video has given you a little insight into the venue. Join me in about 5-10 minutes. I'll show you the rig, I'll show you my bait mix that I'm feeding, and then I'll try and catch a few more fish for you. Come on, thank you. Right then, so as promised, I'm just going to show you the my free lining rig. So starting with the hardware, I've got a Daiwa Whisker 2600 reel, loaded up with 10 pound ESP synchro. The rod is a Daiwa Power Mesh Stalker 9 foot 2¾ rod. So, you know, it's got a nice forgiving soft tip, but if I did hook into one of those bigger fish near the rushes, it's got plenty of power to get them out. But about 2 meter length, a bit of 8 pound surface line, and that's just going down, and it's tied knotless knot to a size 10 NWG hook. So yeah, very simple rig, very simple setup. All I do is just get fishery owned pellets, wet them down for about an hour or two, make them into a nice slop, and then I just add about 2 to 3 slices of bread, mush it all up, make it into a nice slop, feed a few margin swims, and then I literally just go around each swim that I baited up, and I literally just free line bread over the top. It's just as simple as that. Thank you.
There we go.
Bloody hell, it's a big fish now.
Oh, he's big. If I lose, I'm going to be even more annoyed.